Lots of people are taking photos.
At the MWC Mobile Trade Show in Barcelona, a 5G robot can serve you a coffee. The robots from Cloud Minds have hardly any computing power by themselves, and artificial intelligence of the robots come from cloud computing. That means that the robot connected to remote servers, then compute the complicated task of communicating with people and serving the coffee. Normally this would be done with cabled internet or high-speed Wi-Fi connection, but if the robots are going to become truly mobile, they need a connected to the mobile network. The problem is the existing 4G network is too slow, says William Xuan Quing, CloudMind founder.
So the robot itself is now an avatar. It connects to the cloud over mobile network. So what do we need for the network? Low latency, high speed, and ubiquitous coverage. So 5G is needed.
The high-speed connection doesn't prevent the robot from dropping the occasional coffee, but at least it takes responsibility immediately by saying, I screwed up. 5G is a new technical standard for wireless networks. In fifths, naturally, that promises faster speed, less lag or latency when connecting to the network, and the ability to connect many devices to internet without bogging it down. 5G networks will ideally be better able to handle more users, lots of sensor and heavy traffic. At the Ericsson booth, the Swedish company is showing a similar concept where a robot spider is connected to the controller via the 5G network. This is to illustrate that the 5G network has a far lower latency compared to the 4G network. That means that there is almost no delay in the communications. When someone pressed the controller, the robot moves almost instantly. With the 4G network, there would be a delay, making it difficult to control the robot.
So this year is a really exciting year, because this is a year about execution, about real deployment. I think last year was a lot about launches. Now we're really making sure now that our customers can launch, and some of them have already launched. But now it's for real. So this year, 5G is happening. And that is, of course, also what you see here on the floor today.
On the MWC show floor, there is also a 5G-connected playground where people can play virtual reality baseball with each other. Also, it's a way to show how little delay there is in the network. There is also a 5G-connected mini-bleep and 5G-connected drone taxi.
We're looking at billions of new devices being connected to the network, and that's going to take networks that can handle vast numbers of connections. But not only that, you need different types of connections. It's about flexibility. So you need very low power connections to connect up smart agriculture, smart utilities, whereas on the higher end applications, the AI, the VR, the AR, you need very high data rates and low latency. So what you're seeing is a whole new scaling of networks that are able to manage many different applications. It's no longer just about a mobile phone, it's about connecting everything together.
But to most consumers, the first experience of 5G will come from a handheld smartphone. The 5G network promises up to 20 times the download speed, meaning that you will be able to download a full-length movie to your device in a matter of seconds. A number of manufacturers such as LG, ZTE, Samsung and Huawei are showing off 5G-ready smartphones. Gerrit Schiemann, senior smartphone analyst, IHS Markit Research Company, says it's still unclear how regular consumers will benefit and what the cost of accessing the new networks might be.
You have to show what the user benefit is, and I think right now this is still being worked out exactly what that is and how it translates to the end user in terms of device availability, what kind of price point that is, and what kind of price point then also comes with the data plan. Is it going to be similar to LTE plans at the very early stage where carriers had, you know, a premium bump on pricing for LTE access versus other networks? So there's still multiple things that need to be worked out.
Ahead of the opening of MWC, a battle between the US government and the Chinese tech company Huawei over security overshadowed much of the news about 5G networks and 5G devices. The US government dispatched a big delegation to MWC to press its case with telecom executive and government officials that they should not use Huawei as a supplier over national security concerns. US President Donald Trump's administration says the Chinese government could use Huawei equipment to snoop on the world's internet traffic. These are accusations Huawei has rejected, saying there has been no proof of cybersecurity breach.
Well, no, Huawei is definitely blacklisted from America. That's not changing anytime soon. Well, keep in mind, Huawei is not the only game in town when it comes to network equipment, right? We've got Ericsson, we've got Samsung. In fact, the U.S. carriers are actually turning on their 5G networks now, or in the process of doing it. AT&T already has a few networks live in a couple of cities, and that's without the cooperation of Huawei.
Dan Beeler, senior analyst, Forrester Research, says the concern should be taken seriously, but that all networks could be hacked, not just 5G network built by a Chinese company.
You can infiltrate all sorts of networks. It doesn't have to be 5G. You can hack 3G networks. So I would say let's all come down a little bit on this side and look at the potential of 5G over the longer term, the medium term, of course, also, and move into the use case scenarios. And of course, you have to remain on your toes. You need to be very clear as to the risks that are involved in using network technology in general.
MWC, formerly known as a Mobile World Congress in Barcelona, is the world's largest mobile-focused trade fair. Over 100,000 people are expected to visit the show, and some 2,400 exhibitors will be attend to show their latest products. The fair runs through February 28.